All right, Jake Busey, very much his own man. Yes. But as he came in here, I greeted him as he is occasionally greeted, with the suspicion that, gosh, he looks a lot like his famous dad. And you were saying that that has happened to you before.
Occasionally. Mm-hmm. Occasionally 30 or 40 times a day.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, not all.
But here, my mom was a school nurse here in town.
Okay.
So periodically, one out of 1,000 people would come up to me and say, your mom was so nice, and I love that.
Right.
But it only happens to me on the rarest of occasions.
Right.
When it happens 50 times a day.
Well, it happens a lot for me, and I don't mind it. I love it. My dad is an extremely talented man. He was nominated for an Academy Award. Hey, if it weren't for him, I would not be here. In a multitude of aspects.
Yes.
And you know, I'm very thankful, and I do acknowledge that the genetics are there.
Yeah.
But I'd like to get a consortium. I would like to grab Charlie Sheen and Kiefer Sutherland and let's say
Emilio Estevez,
Kate Hudson.
And I'd like to get a little room together, maybe have a little fireside chat and ask them, do they experience the same sort of like, I loved your dad in Apocalypse Now.
Right.
I loved you, you know, that type of thing. But I do. I love my dad. And yeah, genetics are quite a thing.
People love Freakish. You are Earl, who is both immoral and ruthless.
Yeah, yeah. Earl started out a little bit as a one-dimensional kind of like, you're going to be the bad guy. And then, you know, we kind of expanded on that a little bit. And the show's, it's fun. It's the Breakfast Club meets The Walking Dead. Mm-hmm. So for the folks that are high school age, you know, between 17 and 21, or that demographic, the show really kind of, it resonates there. And it's a compelling show. And I was glad to be the old guy.
Oh, and were people coming to you for, did that feel weird to be a little guy?
It was.
Because I tell you what, years ago, Mark and I used to be the youngest people who worked here.
Right.
And now...
time marches on.
And now we reference guys like Chris as Sonny.
Right.
But...
I grew up watching you guys, absolutely.
But we
there you go. There you go.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, I walked
but I'm very young.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It hasn't been that long.
Exactly. Here is a season 2 from Hulu's Freakish Look.
We could have had them. We still don't know if there are others. We have to be patient.
What? I'm starting to get the feeling that maybe you don't want to hurt any of these kids.
My goal is to own this school.
Yeah, but we're not gonna own this school without a few casualties.
Ooh, you are bad.
Yeah, this guy, he had a, well, the idea is before the apocalypse, he was one of these guys that saw himself as the, he's kind of an armchair survivalist. And then once the apocalypse comes, it's his opportunity to sort of take over, and maybe not in the best of ways.
Okay, so, very good.
Yeah.
What about this? You're a motorcycle guy, and you meditate whilst you work on motorcycles?
Well, now, this is interesting when you take things out of context,
right,
put them on a page, and then read them back.
Which is exactly what I just did, by the way.
At one point, I might have mentioned that I was having a hard time getting work as an actor. My wife became pregnant, and as a male, you get this, I've got to provide.
Of course.
And so I don't have any qualifications to do anything. And the only thing I could think of was that I really do like motorcycles, and I was working on The Closer, and I was over at Raleigh Studios, and I saw a bicycle with an engine on it, and I thought, well, now that's pretty cool. So I started making those, and I developed a whole business, and it sort of got us through that period of time of her being pregnant and all the that comes along with it, and being able to pay the bills by making motorcycles.
Oh,
and
wow.
I had become sober at that point. And so I used that as my time just wrenching by myself, building bikes, and it was sort of meditative,
Wow, I want one of those bikes. That sounds really great.
They're fun.
Season 2 of Freakish is streaming now on Hulu. Jake, nice to see you this
morning.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks for being here. Appreciate it.